What is a MotoGP engine? It's the heart of the machine. It's what provides the power to the bike that propels it around the track. If we talk about chassis in MotoGP or any category, it's basically what we call the frame. It's what houses the engine. This is what the engine is built into. And everything connects to the chassis. The front forks, the rear swing arm, the handlebars, the seat, the bodywork, all connect to the chassis. You don't tend to see this on track. It's hidden under the bike, but it's a very important part. It basically binds everything together. If we move to the swing arm off the bike, what is this? This is basically the connection from the frame to the rear wheel. And this is normally made of aluminium or carbon fiber. It's basically there to give that connection from the engine, the power unit, to the rear wheel and allow that bike to be propelled around the track. If we talk about the flex and stiffness of the bike, this relates to the chassis and the swing arm. And what the teams would do, they would change the stiffness of the chassis or the swing arm to suit the rider's needs. When we say flex, the bike will move more, but this will make it a little bit more unstable on the straight. If they make the frame stiffer and the swing arm stiffer, the bike will be more straight line, much better condition, but in the corners won't turn well. So it's a compromise of the chassis and the swing arm to get that flex right for comfort for the rider. We classify the aero body as the fairing, the front mud guards, the wings, the side pods. It has an effect on the braking, it has an effect on straight line speed, turning, and acceleration. So it's finding that compromise that gives a good straight line speed, but allows the bike to turn, or allows the bike to turn, but doesn't give too much speed up. When we said the engine was the heart of the bike, the electronics are the brain of the bikes. Without electronics, the bikes would simply not work. You don't see the electronics, they're hidden away inside the bike, but they are working all the time. You hear people talk about traction control in MotoGP. This is part of the electronics. And what this does, it basically controls the wheel spin of the bike. When the bike rear's wheel starts to spin too much, the electronics take over. It reduces that power. If the wheel is spinning, the bike is not going forward. It also helps the tire life. If the wheel is spinning, as I said, the tire life will get worn out very quickly. The sensors are also very important. They're the nerves, shall we say, of the bike. Now, most MotoGP bikes have around about 60 sensors, and they're working constantly every time that bike is on the track. They work in two ways. Firstly, the sensor will help control the traction control, which we spoke about earlier. The anti-wheelie, they tell the electronics there to do their job, shall we say. And then they're also recording constantly every millimeter of that bike on that track. All this information is stored on electronics. When the bike comes back to the pit box, the data guys will download and they can analyze all this information.